to see about respirations in plants, before going to see the neat questions, we should know about some of the key points about respirations. First, we should know about what is meant by respirations. That is, some of the organisms inhale the oxygen and release the carbon dioxide as well as an energy. That process is called respirations. The organism releases the energy in the form of ATP. ATP is also called a cell currency. The following process takes place in respirations. First, glycolysis. The glycolysis, another name of this glycolysis is EMP process. This glycolysis process takes place in cytoplasms. Here the glucose is converted into 2-pyruvic acid. At the same time, in glycolysis, during glycolysis, this process it will release an ATP, and that is number of ATP is 8. During glycolysis process, it will release 8 ATP. Then following glycolysis, we see about removing of oxidative carbon compounds. That is, this process takes place in mitochondria. In this case, the pyruvic acid is converted into 2-acetyl coenzyme. Then, in presence of air, pyruvic acid is converted into 2-acetyl coenzymes. In absence of air, pyruvic acid is converted into lactic acid or ethanol. Here, 6 ATP is released during oxidative carbon compound, releasing of oxidative carbon compound. During a removing of oxidative carbon compound, 60 ATP is released. Then Grump cycle. Grump cycle, another name for Grump cycle is amplifolic and citric cycle and TCA cycle. TCA means a tricarboxylic acid cycle, and this process is also takes place in mitochondria. Here 2-acetyl coenzyme is converted into carbon dioxide and water molecules. At the same time, we are simply know that the glucose is converted into carbon dioxide plus water in Grump cycles. During a Grump cycle, Grump's process, 24 ATP is released. Then we are going to see about electron transfer systems. This system plays a major role for respirations. This process takes place in inner mitochondria cell membrane. The main process for this system is glucose is converted into carbon dioxide and water. During this process, 38 ATP is released. We should know that during glycolysis, it will release an 8 ATP. Then removing of oxidative carbon compound, it will release only 6 ATP. In Grump cycles, it will release 24 ATP. In electron transfer system, release an 38 ATP. For the decomposition, from the decomposition of glucose, it will release a 38 ATP. We are seeing about a fermentations process. It always takes place in absence of air. At the same time, during this process, it does not release a carbon dioxide. We should know about the fermentation process takes place in absence of air. At the same time, it will not release a carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide here, glucose is converted into ethanol. During this process, 6 ATP is released. Another important key point, that is an RQ. RQ is nothing but respiration coefficient. That is, respiration coefficient means that it is in a ratio between releasing of carbon dioxide and absorbing of oxygen in any chemical reactions. That is, RQ is nothing but the ratio of carbon dioxide as well as an oxygen. If RQ value is 1 for carbohydrate, RQ value is greater than 1 for acid, RQ value is less than 1 for fats. Then RQ value is infinity for fermentation process. It is an important key point. It will help to answer the following neat questions. We will discuss the neat questions in another video. Watch our channels regularly and get more ideas. Thank you.